today from Horizon Minerals is Jon Price. Jon, good to see you. Welcome back.
You too, Andrew. Great to be here.
Look, a few bits of news to catch up on here, Jon. You've made some new acquisitions recently. Tell us a bit more about these projects.
Yeah, the most recent one is the, you know, the projects around Bulong South, which includes the high-grade Cannon underground mine. So we see that as a development-ready asset. We can get in underground and it can be part of our sort of production profile as part of the feasibility study in EU1 and beyond. To the east of that is the Glandore project. So walk-up resource definition targets that are there on fantastic geological structures. And the third element of the acquisition was really the Cowarna project, which is immediately to the east of Silver Lake's Mount Munger operation. Again, we see great exploration potential there and looking forward to getting the acquisition completed and then getting the drill rigs out on the property, as well as completing the feasibility on the Cannon underground.
And in the last couple of weeks, Jon, you've done the Penny's Find JV deal.
Yeah, so that's another real high quality, good grade, plus 5 gram underground in joint venture with our partner, Almanex Limited. So for us, that's slightly different. So we're going to be working on the updated resource. We've completed the drilling, put that into reserve. And by the September quarter of this year, next quarter, in fact, we want to be making a development decision. We have approvals in place for Penny's Find, and we have a toll milling agreement also executed and ready to go for December and March quarters. So this is a cash generation opportunity for us as we complete our study and move into the development decision for our big production profile at the end of this calendar year.
You've announced a solid increase here to the Boorara resource. Talk us through some of these numbers.
Yeah, Boorara is a really important part of our production profile going forward. It is the long mine life baseload operation. And your viewers may have remembered that we did a big trial. That trial was highly successful. It generated $3.6 million in cash. But more importantly for us, it gave us that geological confidence. So we have a 34% increase in grade at Boorara now. And we have a resource model that has been tested in real time through milling, metallurgical, geology. So we're very, very confident now that our main long life baseload pit is going to be a real cracker. And we're going to put the mill, or we propose to put the mill right next door to that. And we're working on that through this calendar year and aiming to have that feasibility out in December.
Well, just on that, where are you as far as progress towards the feasibility study?
Yes, a common theme has been around assay turnaround time, and we haven't been immune to those delays as well. But we're now getting a lot of our backlog completed. We have resources coming out week on week, and we want to be in a position where all of our core development projects, which there are now six of them, including Cannon, will be in updated form in the June-September quarter, be in reserve in the September quarter, and then be consolidated into one production profile. And we're looking for 5 to 7 year initial mine life, and that'll underpin the construction of a 1.5 million tonne per annum processing plant. We're doing all that work in parallel. So we're looking forward to a very exciting, next 6 months, and then being in a strong position to grow the production profile and press the green button.
And given these activities that you've got planned here, Jon, how's the cash looking?
Yeah, we're in a very strong financial position. We've got $13 million in cash and $5.5 million in liquid listed investments. So we've got a very strong balance sheet. We've got drill rigs out on the property, all the independent study work going on. So it's a very busy time, but we're in very good shape from a financial point of view.
Appreciate the update. Good to see you, Jon. Thank you.
Thanks, Andrew.